we've now got a studio of about 16 artists. Bridport's been compared to Notting Hill on Sea, but there's really not much money here. It's a working town, and people actually love it for that. They love the fact that you come down somewhere like St. Michael's Studios or the training estate, and it's still very, it's a very authentic atmosphere. It's not one of these pretentious redevelopments. It's got real atmosphere and vibrancy. The community is wonderful, very supportive, very rich and varied. Music, literature, writing, all sorts. So we've been building up this this artistic movement, and the Bridport art scene is now nationally renowned. But we are part of this big 10-acre estate, which some of which is derelict and is a bit scruffy in places. And of course, the developers have been eyeing it up and smacking their chops and thinking, you know, what can we do here? So we're trying to find out what they want to do and offering our advice as to what we think they should do, and just seeing how it progresses, really. It's quite a difficult situation because we rely on the fact that that we have these low rents, and so any kind of tarting up of the areas, as it were, or tidying up, is going to affect us. And because it's a 10-acre site at the heart of a very small town, it's obviously going to have a major impact on the town itself. So what we're saying is any development has to be extremely well thought out and take into consideration the opinions of local people. I mean, many of the businesses on the estate have been running for 20, 30 years, and they work, you know. So just to sort of move in there and say, we know what's best for you, actually, no, you don't. You know, the architects, for instance, they live in, the architects who have come up with the proposal, they work in Poole. They visited Bridport a couple of times, and they're doing it in collaboration with West Dorset District Council, which is based in Dorchester, which again is a town of very different character to Bridport. It doesn't really have the qualities of individuality and quirkiness that Bridport has. So we're obviously just very concerned that whatever happens here is in the interests of Bridport, not in the interests, the short-term interests of a developer or the kind of utopian nonsense of, you know, government ministers or what have you.